So, the big one, marketing. We've talked about the writing, we've talked about the production, but one of the biggest questions that people come up to me with is, I wrote this book, I wrote it about a year ago, I wrote it 2 years ago, and it's just not selling the way I want it to. What can I do? And that's a big question. One of the things that we really believe is that if you've got the writing down and you've got the production down, the marketing becomes that much easier because you've created a cohesive whole. You've created cohesive branding around a piece that can move forward, and you've created a cohesive team that can move that piece forward without having to say, wait, how is your writing related to the cover? So having those all as a cohesive whole is one of the important elements, the most important elements to a successful marketing and therefore sales of a book. And let's not confuse marketing and sales. We can market all the live long day, but what we really want to do is get that book into the hands of people who not only buy it, but read it. That's the process here. One of the biggest things that I see as a problem, and one of the things that we walk people through the most, is this secret that I'm about to tell you. Everybody has their pens ready. Don't confuse strategy with tactics. Don't confuse strategy with tactics. I am not a military strategist. You do not want me on your paintball team. But I can tell you that there's a big difference between drawing a map and strategizing how we're going to steal the flag from the other team and figuring out that we're going to launch some, well, water grenades, I hope, if it's paintball, right? One is a strategy. The other is simply a tactic. And so when I talk to those authors, they say things like, well, I was going to post some stuff on Facebook. That's a good thing. Please do post some stuff on Facebook. But let's figure out a strategy. Where are you going to post that? Is it a group? Is it a page? How often are you going to post that? To whom will you be posting it? How will you target it? How will it be branded? These are all questions that should be part of your marketing strategy. So please don't confuse tactics with strategy. We had a great presentation yesterday on LinkedIn. LinkedIn can be part of your strategy. Twitter can be part of your strategy. But if you're overlooking the overarching plan, I can tell you that that's one of the huge problems of people who come to me and say, my book just isn't selling the way I want it to. Notice that I said the way I want it to, right? Your standards for how your book sells. Maybe you only want to sell 100. Maybe you want to sell 100,000. We can help you do either, but you need to have the strategy in place to make that happen, which is knowing your goals. What do you want to do with that book? So a strategy is knowing who you want to reach, where they hang out, and what the longevity of that plan is. How long are you going to be doing that? So please do not confuse strategy with tactics. So why a book? Well, Gary told us yesterday when we were talking about the secrets to $100,000 that if you sold 556 books at $15, you would have $100,000. Not too shabby. Anybody here would like to have $100,000 in their pocket right now? Yeah, pretty good. So our best-selling author right now is selling 500,000 books. 500,000 books at $15 is $7.5 million. Anybody like to have $7.5 million? Right, so look, Gary talked to us about how we use our time, right? And a book really isn't considered that PE time. It's gaining you some money at $15 a pop. So we don't talk about that as real money. You know, I talk about that as take your spouse out to dinner money. It's icing on the cake money. It's not the point of writing an entrepreneur book. There might be other books that you want to be revenue generators, but an entrepreneur book is to lead you into the conversation with your client. That said, $100,000 of icing on the cake is pretty sweet. $7.5 million worth of icing on the cake is even sweeter, right? That's before the revenue generation that happens from the book. Because the goal of an entrepreneur book, this is nice icing money, but really it's to augment your business. It's to start that conversation with your ideal client. And by the way, to screen out the people who aren't your ideal client. They should also pick up your book and say, that's not for me. And that's okay, that's exactly what that book should do, because there's somebody else who's a better solution for that person. You want the people coming to you who resonate with your message, with the way that you say things, with the way you explain things, with the systems that you have come up with to solve their unique problems. Make sense? All right, so why a book? Why a book? Because your story matters. And once you can get to a place where you know how to communicate your story well, you know how to communicate your message well, you know how to package that message so that it can get into the hands of the people who desperately need the story that you have to tell, the way that you have to say it, and what you have to say, that's when amazing impact happens. And that's when you're changing lives, not just through a book, but because they're coming to you for your help. And that's magic. That's amazing. That's powerful. What we see as ordinary, others see as extraordinary. Don't overlook the extraordinary in you and the story that you have to tell, share, and create an impact with.